One of the most frequently asked question from the urban housing section in GATE examination is question based on the concept of net and the concept of gross. So let's understand this first concept of gross and net, then we will talk about the gross density and net density. To understand this concept of net and gross, let's take an example. Suppose you own a shop and the total income from that shop, total annual income from that shop is, let's say, 5 lakh rupees, right? Now, suppose you have an employee and you also have to pay salary to that person. You also have to pay the electricity bill. You also have to pay, you know, water bill, another kind of maintenance. So let's say in 1 year, you are supposed to, you know, expense 1 lakh rupees into all these things, which includes, you know, salary, electricity bill, water bill, and other maintenance, right? So the total income, which is the gross income from that particular shop, is 5 lakh rupees, because you are earning 5 lakh rupees. But the net income would be 5 lakh rupees minus 1 lakh rupees, that is 4 lakh rupees. Net is something that you get by subtracting the outgoing. So incoming minus outgoing is equal to net. So this was the general concept of net and gross. Now, how this is, you know, applicable in case of urban housing project? As you all know that in an urban housing project, you won't be just providing the housing block. You will also have to provide schools. You will also have to provide, you know, dispensaries. You will also have to provide green spaces, playgrounds, and other. You also will have to, you know, provide road, etc. So a lot of land goes into all these kind of services. Now, suppose, let's again take an example. There is a housing project of 100 hectares. Now, out of this 100 hectares, let's say 30 hectare has gone into different kind of services, which include school, dispensary, market, you know, park, etc. So the net area of this housing project will be simply 100 hectare, which is the total, minus 30 hectare, which has gone into different kind of services. So net area of this housing project will be 70 hectares, and the gross area is, of course, the total area, which is 100 hectare. So this was the concept of gross and net. Now, this concept of gross and net we can use, you know, to calculate the net density and gross density. You all know that gross density of a housing project will be number of people, which means total population, or number of dwelling unit, total dwelling unit, divided by gross area. Now, similarly, net density will be total number of people, which is the population again, or total dwelling unit, divided by, if it is a net density, then it is divided by net area, right? Sometimes they will directly give you that this, you know, the net area is this much and the gross area is this much. Sometimes they will give you the idea that this much percentage has gone into the services. So you can easily calculate how much will be net area and how much will be gross area. Let's solve a previous question, which is basically asking to calculate net residential density. The question is, a community comprising 120 hectares is having 60% of the land put to residential plot and a population of 30,600. Calculate the net residential density in PPH. This was asked in 2003. So from the question, it is quite clear that since the, you know, total area of that particular, you know, housing project is 120 hectare, so the gross area here is given, 120 hectare. And question says only 60% area is for residential use, which means rest 40% area has gone into different kind of services. So the in this case net area will be, of course, as per the question, 60% of gross area. So net area will be 60% of gross area, which is 120 hectare. If you will solve this, you will get 72 hectare. So in this question, gross area is 120 hectares and net area is 72 hectares. Now the next task is to you to calculate net residential density. So net density, as you we have seen this, net density is equal to, you know, population that is given in the question, 30,600. So let's put the value here, divided by net area. Since they are asking net density, we will use net area, not the total area. So net area is 72 hectares. So if you will solve this, you will divide 30,600 divided by 72, you will get 425% per hectare. It is, in short, it is known as PPH, right? 425 PPH. So option C is the right answer. I think this must be very clear to you now, what is this gross and net area is and how to calculate gross density and net density. If you have any question, you can ask in comment section or on our Facebook page. And also I would like you to, you know, comment on what topic you want us to make our next video. Thank you.